Good morning to all of you. Madam Principal of Rungta College of Science and Technology, Madam Wani, Madam Arjima, faculty of this prestigious institute, and all my students, guests, welcome from different parts of the country. It is indeed a great pleasure for me to be here before you all. And I would like to express my gratitude to the organizer of this prestigious institute who has given me the opportunity to share some of my views before you all. Friends, I am an agricultural scientist. I don't know to what extent the knowledge gained by me and to be delivered before you will be useful to know, useful to you all. I don't know how much I will be able to justify, because as you know very well that I am from agriculture faculty, so definitely you will have a feel of agriculture. And I think it should also be there, because agriculture in India is an agriculture dominating country, and I think nobody can deny it. So feeling of agriculture, I think it must be there. And you will definitely have a feeling of agriculture. You are not from agriculture, you are from science background. But you will see little bit agriculture. And I think I will try my little best to justify the content and the topic which has been assigned to me. I congratulate the organizer for having given me this opportunity. And I also congratulate them for choosing such a very important topic. I think this is the topic nowadays. I remember whenever we talk about information and communication technology, I think we must not forget Mr. Raju Gandhi. I think it is his dream, it is his vision, and his vision was translated. And now I think the present Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, he is further taking it forward. And digital India, you all know very well. And information communication technology, I think we have gone ahead. There is no doubt about it. So friends, I will try to focus something on this particular aspect. I think in the last days, deliberation you must have at length discussion. And I think in my topic also there will be some repetition. So please forgive me for that. If there are repetition, you have to deal with me. Because I was to come yesterday, but due to some urgent assignment, I could not make it. And today I am here. So definitely, I know that some repetitions might have been there. So kindly bear with me. Next, please. So friends, I think there is no need to tell about what ICT is, because it is the second day. But anyway, what ICT is, I think maybe in a different way, you must know about what ICT is. It supports the activities, and these activities are the creation, the storage, the manipulation, and the communication of the information. This is what ICT is, this is what is ICT's, the background behind ICT is. Next, please. Now, it also includes the application and the use of ICT. It has led to the emergence of different forms of telecommunication and microelectronics. Tools such as laptops, desktops, computer network, the internet, the web portals which has been developed by many institutes of the country, then digital printers, and now the mobile technology it is used in a very big way. And I think India is the country where you will find, I think it is the biggest country in the world having use of mobile cell phone, having use of smartphone. And for the information, those who are from outside the state, I wanted to tell them that government of Chhattisgarh is going to distribute about 45 lakhs smartphone to the students, maybe to the farmers, or maybe to the youth of this country, youth of this state. There is a plan by State Planning Commission to distribute about 45 lakhs. I think in the next year it will be distributed, all these smartphones. And I think for the youngsters, for the students, It's going to be a very important tool in their hands. They can operate it, they are operating it already. Then it enables administrators to record, to store, to process, to review, and transmit information. This is very, very important. Next, please. And I was talking about a web portal. Lot of information is there in the web portal. It can be developed by you, it can be developed by your students, it can be developed by your staff. Say for example, this Krishi Gyan portal. I told you that I am from agriculture. Some the examples are definitely from agriculture. So friends, in agriculture, we have developed, and all this knowledge that is called Gyan Krishi portal, Krishi Gyan portal. If you just put these two words in Google search, then you will find the entire information, that is our information. It is all in Hindi, and the information about agriculture, different aspects of agriculture, different aspects of crops, about weed management, about plant protection, about crop varieties, about biodiversity, and about management of different diseases. All these informations you will find in our Krishi Gyan portal developed by us. And this Krishi Gyan portal is regularly updated. And this is the responsibility of me, I mean my director of extension, to update it regularly so that the information, the updated information is available whosoever access this particular portal. So friends, this is available in Hindi only. You can access the information regarding what types of crops are grown in Chhattisgarh, what are the problems, what are the varieties, what are the durations of the crop, and what are the varieties which are resistant to maybe the AYP stresses or the biotic stresses, and the package of practices. Mr. Arnimas was talking about best practices to be adopted in your college. Yesterday I was in a governor house, governor of Chhattisgarh, and I came to know that the President of India has given a circular to all the governors to adopt best practices of their state in the governor house and submit the information to the President house. So I think now it is the era of whatever the best practices are. Madam Mali was talking about that somebody is there who is regularly providing some kind of extract, some kind of extract or juice to the cancer patient regularly to get rid them of the, to get rid of the problem of cancer. So like these best practices are now it is available. Government of India is also talking about use of best practices. Say for example, if best practices are developed for a particular state, then if that can be replicated in other part of the state, I think that should be done and that should be replicated. So that is the, so all kinds of these information you will find in our Krishi Gyan portal. Next week. Now see, this is another portal developed by Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, where it is called TNAU AgriTech portal. TNAU AgriTech portal. So likewise, you can also develop your own portal and you can have your own knowledge so that your students, your staff, your staff, they can access the kind of information you wanted to pass on to them. So here you can see the information on agriculture aspect, on horticulture aspect, on agriculture marketing, agriculture engineering, and what not. Whatever you want your students to know, all these kinds of information can be put in your AgriTech portal. Like you can have your own portal. So all sorts of information which you want, all sorts of courses, syllabus which is going on in your institute, they can be uploaded and they can be there so that student can have easy access to these things, easy access to these information. Next please. Now this is KVK portal. Friends, you must have heard about KVK. KVK is Krishi Vigyan Kendras. We also call it as Farm Science Center. And you will come to know that we have 680 Krishi Vigyan Kendras in India. And I think it is one of the biggest network in the world. And I am at Chhattisgarh. We have 24 Krishi Vigyan Kendras. Each Krishi Vigyan Kendra is having a staff of 16. So this Krishi Vigyan Kendra is meant to transfer the agriculture knowledge to the farmers, to the farming community, so that they can have their, they can develop, they can access those knowledge, and they can develop, they can use their knowledge to increase or to upgrade their livelihood. So KVK Gyan portal, KVK portal has recently last by ministry of agriculture, especially by Mr. Radha Mohan Singh ji. I think it is started very recently. It was launched very recently, only in the year 2017, actually. And what for this is? This is for to monitor the farm center. As I told you that we have 680 farm science center. So the activities of all these farm center can be very well monitored, can be very well regulated, can be very well known which KVK what they are doing. So it can be very well monitored using this KVK portal. Next please. Then apps, mobile apps. I was talking about mobile apps. Now it has become very easy. Our agriculture minister, Mr. Brijmohan Agrawal. Most of you may be knowing about Brijmohan Agrawal. He is a dynamic leader in the state of Chhattisgarh. So he has developed, his son who is a law graduate, he has developed a mobile app called Brijmohan app, Brijmohan Agrawal app. And what that Brijmohan Agrawal app does? Brijmohan Agrawal app capture all the information, any complaint, any solutions, any problem you want to pose before Brijmohan Agrawal, you can raise those issues, go to Google Store, download, and you can enter your mobile number and your registration number will also be there. So, whatever the problems you have which are related to Brijmohan Agrawal and you want the solution from Brijmohan Agrawal, it can be, you can go to his app. And within 7 days, you will find the solution of your problem. It is all registered. So, Dr. Raman Singh ji, Brijmohan Agrawal ji, and many more leaders, now they are handling these kinds of apps so as to gather the information, so as to solve the problem, not only to gather the questions, to gather the information, but they also wanted to solve your problems, what actually your problems are. So friends, this kind of mobile apps are there. You will find varieties and number of mobile apps are available. Maybe for education also, maybe for your different technologies also. Now this is one of the app developed by one of my colleague in Agriculture University. He is Dr. Ravi Sachena, and he has developed an app. This is development of e-graph app. Many of you from the botany background also, you will be knowing about plant diseases. So plant diseases, they pose a lot of problems. There are fungal diseases, bacterial diseases, viral diseases, phytoplasma diseases, protozoan diseases, and what not. So all these diseases, how to identify the disease, what are the remedies to take care of the disease, all sorts of these informations is very well available in this e-crop doctor. This e-crop doctor is an app. It is an application software running on mobile app, both online and offline. The beauty of this app is offline also you can run it, and to advise the farmers regarding easy identification of diseases and even some of the insect pests also, and nutritional deficiencies also. And based on those pictures captured by this app, you can come to know that your problem, your symptom is of which disease and what are the remedies for that particular. So this is a app developed by, this is called e-graph doctor, and using this e-graph doctor you can come to know the different disease problem, insect problem, and you can suggest these suitable remedies to get rid of the problem. Next please. Now you can see this is graph doctor. If you have some insect problem, you have some disease problem, you have some nutrient problem, you just click on disease, you will see number of diseases. Now if you go to the field and come out with some kind of symptoms on maybe on leaf, maybe on stem, or maybe on fruits, then you just match those symptoms from the existing data available here. Or there is a provision in this app also that you can capture the information, even you can with your cell phone, you can take the picture, capture the picture, and you can send also. And that way also you will get the solution from Dr. Saxena app, that which problem this is and this is the solution. So I think now ICT has made us easier in identification of the disease, in identification of the pest, in identification of the plant which is suffering from some nutritional disorders also. Next. Now AgriDutch, which is again a kind of system, expert system. It emulates the interaction a user might have with a human expert to solve a problem. It is meant to enhance the efficiency of farmers, of agricultural extension, personal for crop management, and to increase the crop yield. Similar kind of apps can be developed by you also, keeping in view of your area. Next, please. Next. This is an expert system for different crops. Like different crops, you can develop the expert system. Likewise, in whatever field you wanted to have this kind of information, it can be developed. Next, please. Mushroom agriculture. Again, madam, principal was talking to organize a workshop where students and staff can be invited and they can be trained in mushroom growing. So this is the mushroom dust. Means by operating or by getting information from this particular app or from this particular expert system, you can come to know what are the method of crop production technology, what are the method of crop production technology, what are the problems. Everything is there. You have to just access and you will come to know the solution. Pest and disease model gives detail about the insect pest, nematodes, flies, springtail. Several problems are there which can be even a spawn production technology. Madam Amadeva was talking about a spawn production technology. You can just go to this mushroom agri Dutch program. You can download it. You will find all sorts of information related to mushroom spawn production, crop production, mushroom even mushroom marketing. You will find the even the list of buyers also. Next please. The Grameen Krishi Mushroom Seva Project. This is again a under this we have got a award in this particular GKMS. We have given the information using this app to the many to the large number of farmers, and lot of very good work has been done in our university. So at the center at the national level we got the award particularly for this. Here using this particular software, we have been providing the weather-based agro advisories for the benefit of the farming community. And this weather-based agro advisory is given twice in a week, that is on Tuesday and Friday. What the farmer has to do depending on the weather conditions, we predict and we advise the farmers what to do in a week. So we advise them twice in a week what to do and what not to do. So using this information by the farming community, they have utilized this kind of information, this kind of knowledge, and they have upgraded and even saved lot of money in spraying of pesticide or in using this advisory we forecast the disease. When disease, the chances of or appearance of disease will be there, the chances of occurrence of the pest will be there. So these informations, a farmer is aware, then he can decrease the resources, lot of resources putting in for the protection of the plants. Next please. The sky wind weather. All the informations related to weather can be very well available using this sky wind weather. Next please. Agro-Star farmer app. Agro-Star. For agriculture, whatever the kinds of input you want, door-to-door delivery is there even. Direct to farmer technology platform, where any input, if you want to cultivate paddy, what kinds of input you require for cultivation of paddy, all these are available in this particular app. Even whatever the inputs you want, it will be delivered to you in your house directly. Next please. Now what ICT is? ICT is the major driving force behind other developments as knowledge society, globalization, and it is not only lead to the new digital skill, but also changes the characteristics of most of the existing skills also. And the main challenge for education is make choices about what and when, and secondly, make good and effective use of ICT. Next please. Now, why ICT is required? If I ask you why ICT is required, then I think these are the solutions which ICT can provide you. The first is, a tremendous growth in the higher education sector had been had made the administration of higher education institutions very complex. Today, Santosh Rungta ji is not here, otherwise you would have experienced how much problem is being faced by in administration, because Madam was talking about 700 students are admitting every year. Managing those 700 students is not a easy task. So using ICT, this task can be become easier. It can be become easier. ICT plays a vital role in supporting powerful, efficient management, in reducing operational inefficiency, and improving decision making. These are the very important advantages in many areas of governance and administration in education sector. Here I think, as an administrator, you need ICT very, very important for the administrator especially. ICT has become a necessary tool for accomplishing the administrative task, which is, it has changed the very nature of the higher education, allowing information to be transferred, to be stored, to be retrieved, and processed by almost all who were study or interact with a given institution. There is an increase in managerial effectiveness also, and efficiency in working also through using ICTs. Next is, ICT also enhances day-to-day management. It is very, very important for the administrator. Day-to-day management of institutions and in various functional areas in which it will be used. For example, timetable, to prepare the timetable for 700 students is a difficult task. Student admission and tracking their record. बहुत सारे तो क्लास में ही नहीं आते, माँ बाप को पत्र लिखे पड़ते हैं, चिट्ठी में भी पढ़ते हैं, लेकिन ये आईसीटी जो है, आईसीटी इतना पावरफुल टूल है कि चिप्स लगा दो आपके अंदर, कहाँ आप जा रहे हैं वो भी पता लग जाएगा, जो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर आपका बैठा हुआ है. मोदी जी आजकल कितना पैसा, राजीव गांधी कहते थे कि दिल्ली से एक रुपया निकलता है और वो ग्राउंड लेवल तक बॉर्डर में आते आते 15 पैसे पहुंच जाता है. अब ऐसा नहीं, मोदी जी 1 रुपये दिल्ली से देते हैं और 1 रुपये कहाँ कहाँ ट्रेवल करते हुए किसके पास जा रहा है, पूरा ट्रैकिंग मोदी जी के पास है. दिल्ली से कहाँ से पैसा निकला है, कहाँ गया है, किसके पास गया है, किसने कितना खाया है और कहाँ तक जिसको जाना था वहां तक कितना पहुंचा है. द एंटायर रिकॉर्ड इज पॉसिबल only due to this ICT business. Then financial management, this has become very, very important. I tell you, a team of World Bank came to our university, and before funding a project, a mega project is coming to our university, and before funding a project, a team of World Bank visited our university. Do you know for what? They wanted to know what is your financial management system existing, then only will be able to provide you the fund, otherwise not. So they came to know in what ways, what are the means, how you are handling the fund. And when they came to know the kind of handling, how we are handling the fund and how we are dealing with the funds management system, then we were extremely happy, and I think within no time we are going to get a mega project by the World Bank. Then medical services, procurement and store management, then data distribution and management, this again very, very important, where ICT can help a lot. That is why I think ICT is required. Next please. Next, ICT greatly enhance educational administrative performance through improving cross communication at the managerial level. Quick access to media information provides media enhances information accuracy, analyzing data fast and effectively, and then there are so many, reduces the workload also, helps administrators in result processing, evaluation of the staff and the students is made easier, enhances research skills of the administrator. This was not possible in the earlier days without ICT, but now administrator, by sitting at his own table, he can monitor. Santosh Rungta ji, By sitting at his table, he monitors the whole population. It is a group of
institution, Rungta group of institution. Everything is in the radar of Mr. Santosh Rungta. और कौन कहा जा रहा है? It is with him. कौन स्टूडेंट को कोचिंग की जरूरत है? कौन कितना दक्ष है? किसका प्लेसमेंट कौन सी कंपनी में हो सकता है? I had at length interaction with him and I came to know he is a real administrator and making use of the ICT. He knows सबसे गधे से गधे स्टूडेंट को भी कहां एब्जॉर्ब करवाना है. He knows very well. And this is the reason why शायद 30-35 कॉलेज बंद हो गए होंगे, लेकिन रुंगटा कॉलेज में अभी भी इनटेक का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. नेक्स्ट व्हाट आईसीटी टूल्स आर यू ऑल नोइंग वेल अबाउट कंप्यूटर्स दे कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर एक्सटेंसिवली फॉर इफेक्टिव एजुकेशनल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लाइक जनरल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लाइक पेरोल फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ स्टूडेंट डाटा इन्वेंटरी मैनेजमेंट पर्सनल रिकॉर्ड मेंटेनेंस and library system. Library is very very important. You have to have the information all around the globe to access to know what is going on, where is going on. Then use of ICT, communication, general administration, these are the two main areas in the management of education institutes. We are talking about higher education institutes, so I think communication, general administration, these are the two very very important pillars of the higher education. And administrative activities in a higher education institution, it consists of personal administration, student administration, staff and resource administration, communication and general administration. Next please. The student administration, I think in higher education, the main beneficiaries, the main stakeholders are, one is the student, another is the staff, finance, resource. These are the four, five things which you have to manage. So in higher education, the difficulty is not that much. लेकिन कहा जाता है कि विद्यार्थी बंदर होते हैं, इसलिए difficulty कई बार बढ़ जाती है. So student administration is again a very important integral part of information administration and which includes the which involves the various activities and it comes in from the admission process to learning activities till processing of results and performance. दूसरा है the integration of ICT into this process enhances the overall administration activities of higher education institution by making it more accessible. Next. Now it also relates the automation of admission process. Through e-media, including admission required by students, applying for admissions through electronic media, registration, enrollment using computers, I think it is all being followed by you, Madam Principal. I think it is all being followed by you in your institute also. Then course allotment, availability of information like timetable, class schedule, electronic form, attending, monitoring, maintenance. Then communication relating to transport, hotel accommodation. Students, most of the students are from outside, so you need the hotel accommodation also and. Hostel administration also. The warden has to put in a lot of efforts. कौन सी लड़की कहाँ जा रही है, किसके साथ जा रही है, बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है. वार्डन को जानना बहुत जरूरी है कि कौन सी लड़की कहाँ है और किसके साथ घूमती है और कहाँ घूमती है, कब घूमती है. Next. Friends, keeping in view of all these, our honorable vice chancellor Dr. S. K. Patil, who is junior to me even, he has a very good vision, he has a very good innovative ideas, and he got second term and he has developed this IGMIS model. And our university is operating through this model. Our student, our staff, our finance, our economic, everything is now become E. You are getting the E. So everything in our university has become E. So it is an initiative by the Honorable Vice Chancellor to improve the mobile experience of all eligible students, staff and faculty. And these are the features of our student faculty are available. Student corner, we have given in IGMIS, we have given a separate corner for student, separate corner for staff. जब मर्जी हो अपने student corner में उसको information जो उससे related है चली जाती है. Staff को information चली जाती है. जो स्टूडेंट को इंफॉर्मेशन जाती है
स्टूडेंट प्रोफाइल है उसमें, रजिस्ट्रेशन रिजल्ट लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन फिनिशिंग। उसके पिताजी चाहे तो उस बच्चे का रिजल्ट अपने घर से देख सकते हैं, किसी भी किसी के यहाँ जाकर भी, यदि इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी है तो वहां जाकर के जब चाहे तब बच्चे का रिजल्ट देख सकते हैं। ठीक उसी प्रकार से स्टाफ फैकल्टी पार्टनर है, एम्प्लॉई प्रोफाइल है, लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन है, पे स्लिप है, एवरीथिंग। वी नेवर डाउनलोड, यू कैन डाउनलोड दिस पे स्लिप इफ यू रिक्वायर, अदरवाइज इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी। नेक्स्ट इस आईजी के भी एमआईएस मोबाइल ऐप, इसे आगे इट इज एन एंड्रॉइड बेस्ड मोबाइल ऐप फीचर्स स्टूडेंट कॉर्नर एंड फैकल्टी कॉर्नर फॉर द यूनिवर्सिटी एंड द यूनिवर्सिटी फैकल्टीज रिसीव देयर पर्सनल पर्सनल इंफॉर्मेशन पे स्लिप्स लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन एंड अपडेट्स आल्सो। द ऐप वाज लॉन्च्ड ऑन 20th जनवरी 2016 बाय द ऑनरेबल स्पीकर ऑफ छत्तीसगढ़ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली मिस्टर गौरी शंकर अग्रवाल इन वन ऑफ द प्रोग्राम and it is available on Google Play Store. You can go and download this app and you can access all sorts of information. So this kind of app can be designed by many of you, many of your staff, and it can be made easily available to all of you. So this is the app developed by your university. This is IGBVMIS and we have student corner, employee corner. Next please. You can say, for example, this is a student. You can go to home page, you can go to corner, you can go to, you will have his registration card, you can see the station, first semester, second semester. Next please. This is same sir, if you just click Utkarsh Sharma, then all the information related to him will be coming. You will see the basic detail of Utkarsh Sharma, you will see the entire results of Utkarsh Sharma, and all the details are available. And these can be accessed, these are accessible. Wherever you like to access. Next please. Now similarly, staff administration. It includes recruitment, work allotment of faculty and staff in the institution, their attendance, leave management, then performance appraisal. In our university, it is going to be now mandatory that nobody can submit his CR or hard copy is not allowed. It will not be permitted from the next year, from 17-18. We have to submit our CR online. So online CR will be submitted. So that way performance appraisal is very very important. What Modi ji is saying, 50 ke baad jo kaam nahi karta, uski CR bulao aur usko ghar ravanagi kar do. This is going to happen. 5-6 IAS ke upar gaal gir chuki Chhattisgarh raj mein. Mujhe nahi malum dusri jagah kya haal hai. Mujhe malum hai Gujarat mein kai ki upar gaal gir chuki hai. So those who are not working properly, those who are not performing, they don't deserve to get the taxpayers' money. They should be in their home only. So this kind of this performance appraisal is now becoming online in your institute, and the whosoever is the administrator, he can very well see, and he can decide. Then the staff administration through ICT has the processing of the voluminous records very quickly, very meticulously, regularly, and making data retrieval easier. Next please. Then general administration. A very important part of information administration is general administration in higher education or in higher education institute, day-to-day activities. Then the integration of ICT into general administration has brought increased efficiency and optimal resource utilization. And the various ways and which include under this category are like say usage of electronic media for scheduling of halls and other resources, fee payment. Now in our university all fee payment is made by only the online, handling of internal external examination activities in coordination with the faculty members, then all day-to-day activities, intra and intercommunication. So all these things can be done under the general administration. Next please. Use of ICT in educational institutional administration, these things can be done. Next, what is administration? I think administration, it is the process of planning, it is the process of planning activities and utilizing human and material resources with an objective of accomplishing of goals and objectives of a particular organization or institution,
and the class capability of the administrators to make the right decision at the right time to fulfill the predetermined goals. I think for the administrator, this is very, very important. Very, very important. Extremely important. A vice chancellor, if he has to run the university, he should know how to administer the university. You should know very well about the various stakeholders. Then you can successfully run the university. I would just like to cite one example. Our university was started in the year 1987. And we have seen many most experienced vice chancellor of the country to be the vice chancellor of our university. But I tell you, friends, which could have been taken place by Dr. S.K. Patil in last 5 years, and the 6th year is running, I tell you, these achievements of this 6 year has made our university on the top, you can say. I would say in the top. It is not on the top, but I would say ki hum logon ne kahan se kahan chhalang lagayi hai. Main aapko bataunga why administrator required ICT, you will come to know. Next one. Now, what good administration does? I think many researchers, it has clearly revealed that the integration of IT helps to reduce the complexity, to enhance the overall administration of higher education. And I think those administrators who has utilized ICT, they have made the institution, and the institution has gone ahead like anything. Next please. This is the result of a good administrator. Good administrator. IGKV is ranked number 17th among agricultural universities of the country. We were nowhere 6 years back. There are 72 agricultural universities in the country. Now our university has gone at the 17th position in the recent ranking of agricultural university by Indian Council of Agricultural Research. This could have been possible only by the administrator who knows the strength of ICT and he has utilized it. That is why not only this. And we have left behind even IGT. I am a product from Jawaharlal Nehru Agricultural University. This university was started in 1964. It's a very old university. Very big girls were there. This university was known in the country. But now, JNKVB has gone down. Even IGKV, IGKV is the university. It came into existence only in 1987. Now, why I am quoting this example? This is the strength of administration. Our 165 students, what Dr. Patil has done, he has provided the facility, created the facility. Our all hostel, they are Wi-Fi. Our all, the entire campus is Wi-Fi like your Rungta. And the result is, our 165 students have qualified NET examination this year in 1917, and we are fifth in the country. In 2016, our 85 students qualified NET and we were second in the country. Imagine, among 72 agricultural universities of the country, we are nowhere. But I tell you, these are the results. The third very important result is, received 5 national awards. 5 national awards. Half dozens of best research center awards. And ICR best educational awards, which is my directorate. We have 24 research and Vishwavidyalaya Kendras. We have got 3 national awards by Indian Council of Agricultural Research, by plant protection, by protection of plant varieties and farmers' rights, that is government of India. And one award which we have got recently is, it is on the e-governance. So, these are the results of a good administration. Next. Rashtriya e-governance Puraskar. This was given to the Honorable Vice Chancellor for Development of IGMIS in University. I tell you, even ICR, having running so many institutes in the country, even at IRA, which is the premier organization, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi, even they have not developed this kind of software, this kind of e-governance software. And we got
We got this award in the year 2017, 10th of January, and it was given by the Honorable Minister.
Next, please.
Then establishment of agriculture museum. I tell you, we have developed this agriculture museum. This is an example in the country, I tell you. This is an example in the country. It is a country's bigger advanced infrastructure ICT-based agriculture museum, which is at Indira Gandhi Agriculture University. It was inaugurated by Union Agriculture Minister Mr. Mansingh on 12th of September 2016. And it is a rich source of latest information on agriculture and allied sector technologies for the farmers and for different stakeholders, whosoever is coming to view this museum. Next week. This is our agriculture museum. It is wonderful. You are all requested from my side to please do visit it whenever you find time. You will see this is an encyclopedia of various kinds of information. जिस दिन इंटरव्यू जाने जाना है 2 घंटे पहले आ जाना, एग्रीकल्चर से रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन तो आ जाना 2 घंटे स्पेयर, टू आवर्स इन दिस म्यूजियम, यू विल अपडेटेड द रीसेंट टेक्नोलॉजी रीसेंट नॉलेज. ये देखिए इनॉग्रेशन ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर म्यूजियम बाय द ऑनरेबल राधा मोहन सिंह जी, बाय द बलराम जी दास टंडन गवर्नर, बाय द एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर नेक्स्ट प्लीज, बाय द चीफ मिनिस्टर. एंड दिस कुड हैव बीन पॉसिबल बाय the vision of our honorable vice chancellor. It is the it is the combination of information and communication both. It is wonderful example, you can say. Next, please. Farmers, students, dignitaries from several countries also, several states also, students of Chhattisgarh from outside, World Banking and what not, they have all visited. And I tell you, our museum has completed only 1 year 3 months. And I tell you, more than a lakh people have visited the museum, and they have appreciated the efforts of the Vice Chancellor and efforts of our people. Next, please. You can see the list of museum visitors, next, in different months of the year. And in the first floor, these are the information given, which we have displayed. Next, please. And this is on the second floor. Next, please. And strengthening frontline extension program of the university to promote knowledge-based agriculture. Recently, we are going to sign MOU with Manage Government of India Institute in Hyderabad, and they are the expert of this particular field also. So we are going to develop a center of knowledge management and technology delivery network. And what does the center will do? This center will transform them into the ready-to-use formats for a Kisan studio and dynamic knowledge delivery system. So this will be useful for the students, for the network of smartphones, community radio services, activities and colleges. We are going to build up these facilities very shortly. Then challenges for education. Madam Vani, here are the challenges what you have to do for your student. These are the challenges before you. Next, please. But there are some hurdles. What hurdles are, you have to address these hurdles also. What hurdles are? Students, are you ready? The first point, are you ready? Do you agree with the first point? Students, more ICT savvy than teachers. Over 40% of teachers do not feel confident enough to teach ICT skills. Is it true? Yes or no?
Yes.
No or yes? Na mujhe pata lag raha hai no ka, na pata lag raha hai yes ka.
Unke samne teachers baithe hain kaise?
Arey bol dijiye teachers ko, main bol deta hu zara aaj aaya.
Bolo.
Bolo. Aap bol dijiye. Teachers, student ke aur teachers ke liye hai na yahan kuch. Teachers के लिए तो लिख दिया है ना. Then second is the even students are not very well skilled in content related ICT skills like information processing skills, then logical thinking, then lack of vision on how education can and should develop and how ICT fits into it. Next, what needs to be done? Infrastructure is not enough. You will agree with me? संतोष सुमिता जी का कॉलेज यहाँ सब है, बट थिंक ऑफ अदर्स. द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज नॉट एनफ, नॉर कैन इम्प्लीमेंटेशन बी लेफ्ट टू द लोन वॉल. balance needed between the vision, expertise, digital learning, materials and ICT infrastructure. And then the first and foremost professionalization of the teachers. I think this needs to be improved a lot. Next thing. The knowledge society. The knowledge economy in society depends on four factors. One is production of knowledge. Second is the transmission of knowledge. Third is the dissemination of knowledge. And fourth is the use of knowledge in technological innovation. I think the education system, especially the universities, they have to play an important role in these four fundamental ideas, because this is the baby of education, this is the baby of universities. And knowledge society, universities in India, they are called the knowledge hub, they are called the knowledge society. So these are the primary responsibilities of the university. And technology and education, we have to integrate both of them. Madam, you are from education. Those who are from science, they will not respect madam. Oh, she is from education. Bachelor, B.Ed, M.Ed, kya karna humko isse? Science ka education se koi matlab nahi. So science ko jab tak education se jodenge nahi. Unless you integrate both, it will be difficult. Now, public policies must ensure all students have access to technology-based opportunities, software, and the internet also. In many colleges, many universities, not universities, but colleges, there are a number of colleges which are away from the headquarters. They do not have access to the internet. So it is very, very important. Technology is integrated into teaching and learning. Technology transforms education practice by empowering students and individualizing learning. Increased resources for teaching and training as a critical component to ensure technology is appropriately and effectively integrated into the curriculum. This is the responsibility of only higher education or universities like us. Next, please. Next. Develop effective and close cooperation between industry, universities and industry. I remember because I was deeply involved in preparation of the RUSA draft. And RUSA, you all know very well that about RUSA. Now, we think that the coordination between university and industry is totally dispatched. There is no connect between the industries and university. I think and I strongly believe that it should not be. It should not be. It should not be, क्योंकि बहुत सारा रिसर्च जो हमारे यहाँ हो सकता है वो अंबानी बंधु वो सारा पैसा अमेरिका को देते हैं वो रिसर्च कराने के लिए. क्यों? क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ रिसर्च का यूनिवर्सिटी का इंडस्ट्री का कोई लिंकेज नहीं है. आई थिंक दिस लिंकेज हैज टू बी वेरी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. देन ओनली आई वॉज इन चाइना एंड आई टेल यू चाइना में जो एडिबल खंडे रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट है, which is the organization of Shanghai Academy of Agricultural Science. At Shanghai in China is like Mumbai in India. So Shanghai, there is Edible Fungi Research Institute. In that institute, I find the professors of that institute were the partner in one of the mushroom growing company. I was shocked how the professor can be the partner in a company of mushroom. And mushroom growing. So there was an understanding that whatever the new technology is developed by Edible Fungi Research Institute will be given to the company, and company in return will give due weightage, due dividend to the professors. So this kind of linkage between the knowledge generating centers, means university, and beneficiary or industry is not at all there. In RUSA, this concept was realized, but I don't know how far it has been implemented or it is being implementing, I don't know. But I very strongly feel that the basic research or the industry, whatever they are researching, that should be the demand of the industry. And it should be need-based research. Abhi to kya hota hai ki air condition mein baith karke चूंकि रिसर्च करना है तो बना लो प्रोजेक्ट, दे दो प्रोजेक्ट, आ गया प्रोजेक्ट, हो गया प्रोजेक्ट, खत्म हो गया, पता लगा उस प्रोजेक्ट का आउटकम किसी के काम का नहीं है.
I am an agriculture scientist, I tell you, 85% of the 85% of the research data generated or the information or the technology or the knowledge generated by the agriculture university is not going to the farmer's field. It is simply lying in the research report, simply lying in the research paper, simply lying in the research journal. What is the meaning it has? We are the person from the poor country. Our tax payer money is going only for the research. This kind of research which is not at all useful to the people. 85%. So what now has been realized at the national level is stop research. Some kind of basic research or some kind of stop and go for extension. And whatever you have done, transfer it to the field. Get the result. Modi has very strongly given a warning to all most of the institute like CMAP, CMAP, then CSIR. Clear cut instruction has been given. If you do not produce the quality research, do not produce the outcome which is relevant to the stakeholders, don't do such kind of research. We don't need. So, friends, we have to very clearly see what are the expectations of industry, try to fulfill them. And if your research has no meaning, I think it should be stopped. It has no meaning, then it should be stopped. So, main mechanism through which the knowledge and expertise processed and developed by universities can flow directly to the industry, licensing of university intellectual property right, which is happening, spin-off and startup companies. Now again, Modi is giving a lot of emphasis on this. The industry-based research. I do agree, and I think you will also agree with me. यदि ऐसे ज्ञान का कोई मतलब नहीं है, जिसको पढ़ने के बाद उसका उपयोग ना किया जा सके. मेरे यहाँ भी 3 दिन की ट्रेनिंग चल रही है और वो स्किल सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोग्राम है. यदि आपके पास जो ज्ञान है, आपने ज्ञान किसी को दिया, यदि उस ज्ञान के सामने वाले को उपयोग नहीं किया या नहीं कर पाया, तो आपके ज्ञान का कोई मतलब नहीं है. उसको उस पीएचडी को, उस एमएससी को अपने जेब में रख लेंगे. इफ यू कैन नॉट ट्रेन, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम मशरूम साइंटिस्ट एंड इफ आई कैन नॉट टेल माई आई कैन नॉट प्रोड्यूस 100 ग्रोवर्स और 1000 ग्रोवर्स और आई कैन नॉट मेक माई पीपल ग्रोइंग मशरूम, then I can, my technology has no meaning. So, यदि मैं मशरूम साइंटिस्ट हूँ, तो I should see that mushroom is growing by my stakeholders. Whosoever is growing mushroom. Likewise, what I mean to say is, I think you got my point. Next is the emergence of new expectations. These are the expectations from the people. Alongside its fundamental vision of initial training, universities must gather for new needs in education and training stemming from the knowledge-based economy and society also. An increasing need for scientific and technical education, opportunities for lifelong learning, close involvement in community life. Next, I think the last two, mobility of students, research. These are some of the things which needs to be addressed properly. Next, India, no doubt India is running as an IT superpower. Why it is? You can see the data. Next. IT skills in demand. You can see the demand is also there. We are progressing ahead. Next, please. New areas of advanced education. I think these are the field. My dear young fellows, budding scientists, you have to switch on to these areas. These are the new areas of advanced education in which if you put your hands, you will be known all around the globe. So what you have to do is see these areas. See them, try to build up your capacity on these new areas so that you will be settled. तब तो PhD का, diploma का और संतोष रुंगटा जी के यहाँ पढ़कर के 1 लाख रुपए पर ईयर देकर के पढ़ने का पेरेंट्स को आपको कुछ फायदा होगा. So you have to prove, you have to give the outcome. वो जमाना गया पढ़ करके बेकार. अब तो आपको प्रूव करना पड़ेगा. सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दीज आर द न्यू एरियाज वेयर यू हैव टू स्विच ऑन. सी दीज एरियाज, ड्रीम इन दीज एरियाज, ट्राई टू डेवलप द एक्सपर्टाइज इन दीज एरियाज, सो यू विल बी नोन ऑल अराउंड द ग्लोब. नेक्स्ट, बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, बायोइन्फॉर्मेटिक्स, बायोकंप्यूटर, एनवायरमेंटल टेक्नोलॉजी, मैनेजमेंट ऑफ आईटी, एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी मैनेजमेंट. नेक्स्ट, दीज आर द न्यू एरियाज.
And this is the last slide, I think, India poised for the explosive growth in ICT. India emerging as a global, and we have from brain drain to brain gain. We have drained a lot of brain from India. Our time has come to gain brain from India. Gain brain from outside to India. Then millions of jobs will be created in ICT and other emerging technology areas. Quality issues will have to be definitely addressed. Private sector, world-class institutions. They will emerge with global collaborations, and India will reclaim its ancient heritage of the world's most advanced knowledge-based civilization called Bharat. वो भारत जो सोने की चिड़िया कहा जाता था, जिसको माननीय प्रधानमंत्री चाह रहे हैं फिर से सोने की चिड़िया हो, वो कैसे होगी? How ICT can help you in making सोने की चिड़िया वाला हिंदुस्तान कैसे हो? I think ICT can play a very important role, and you are all, I wish you all the best. I wish you all a very happy new year. And I pray the Almighty to make you self-motivated, self-esteemed, and self-motivated, self-inspired, so that you can know these different branches of science, and you can work for your country, you can work for your society, and you can build India as a very strong nation in the globe. Thank you very much. I again extend my gratitude to the organizer who have given me this opportunity to share some of my views. If you have some queries, then please welcome. किसी का कोई प्रश्न नहीं है? मतलब छक्का चौका क्या लगा? हाँ छक्का चौका के नीचे
सर एक वर्ड आप थोड़ा सा
आप
वो बंदर वाला वर्ड थोड़ा सा अच्छा नहीं लगा
कौन सा
बंदर
अच्छा बंदर आई एम सॉरी यदि आपको बुरा लगा तो बंदर बंदर मेरा सेंस में था कि जो बच्चे होते हैं ना रेस्पेक्ट होते हैं जैसे कृष्ण का नहीं आप ठीक है कृष्ण का नहीं आप कृष्ण का नहीं आप बंदर नहीं मेरा मतलब नटखट से था नटखट चाइल्डहुड किसको कौन है थोड़ा हाथ उठाइए किसको बेकार लगा आप स्टूडेंट है स्टाफ है स्टाफ तो स्टूडेंट को बेकार लगना चाहिए था आपके लिए तो था ही नहीं वो चलिए नेक्स्ट
स्टूडेंट अपनी है
नो वन देन थैंक यू वेरी मच
Their time limit is only 10 minutes. Okay, so you can't go beyond 10 minutes. I'll try to sum it up in 10 minutes. Okay. Good morning, everyone. Today, I am on behalf of GD Rungta College presenting a oral presentation in ICT. Okay, since yesterday, we are hearing about the word ICT. Okay, what is this ICT? Since morning, we are all gathered here to gain some knowledge on ICT. ICT is a word stands for information, communication and technology. But in these 2 days, what kind of information you have gained through the communication which is going on here and medium of technology? That is important, the main motto of this 2 days seminar. Okay, my topic is impact of big data on ICT. Okay, what is data according to you? Suppose I say a word white or 15 feet. What do you understand by these two words? Okay, white is a color, but what it specifies? The screen of this projector is white. That is an information, and white is the word data. Similarly for 15 feet, the height of this room is around 15 feet. This is a complete information, but not a data. The combination of a data makes an information. And this information which is provided to us in a way of communication. We all deal with various kind of informations which evolves around us. We all are living in a technology world where each and every person is having a smartphone. And this smartphone, we all are users of various social networking sites like Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, Insta and so on. Every second we produce a large amount of data through images, text, videos, songs, etc. All this data, where it goes, where all this data is utilized, what is done with the data, we are going to see in our next slides. So the word big data, this three letter word, is not just enough to justify the amount of data which evolves in our network. Thousands of users are there in a college campus who use mobile as their main motto or main purpose to communicate with the outside world. Similarly, all of you are using various you are having Facebook IDs. So what you do in Facebook? You post your status, you post your photographs, any event, all this are collected by Facebook and they gather it and process it. Okay, this is the term big data. If you only can generate 15 photographs at a day, so how many users are using Facebook simultaneously? So can you imagine the number of data which is collected by just a Facebook site? Similarly, there are various other sites like Amazon, an e-commerce site, okay, email, browsers, YouTubes, all this produce a large amount of data. This data is well processed and well used by various data analysts. Next slide, please. Okay, so now all of us are aware about the term big data. Okay, next slide. These are the sources, various apps or various websites through which we get this data. We human beings generate this data. Okay. See, first main important source of big data is transaction. All of us are having, I think, bank accounts, and in that every minute we have a transaction. Due to that transaction, a several numbers of data has been generated. This data is used by the bank holder as well as the government of India to keep the record of each and every minute's transaction which is going on in his country. Okay. Next is social networking site, as all are aware about the data which is generated in it. E-commerce sites like Amazon, Flipkart. Okay, suppose in Flipkart, if there is no data available, if you are not able to choose a product, then how you will buy it? So it is very important for such sites to maintain the data. Your Gmail, your email processing. You all might be having certain emails like, in your spam. There are certain emails which are unwanted to you, like a free advertisement or an lottery winning email. that are the raw emails or an unwanted emails which travels in your Gmail. Next is railway. In Indian Railway, it's having a huge amount of data, IRCTC sites. That's why the speed of that site is very okay. Next slide, please. Yes. The data which is there in our network, it's 10% only structured and 90% which is unstructured. So what is done with that unstructured data? Next slide. See, these are the certain facts which is given on based on a 60-second analysis. How many tweets have been produced in 60 seconds, how many web users are there, how many posts have been updated, there are certain numbers which have been displayed here. Next slide. What is done with this big data? So this data needs to be handled very carefully. First, it has been analyzed by various data analysts. This data analyst, they analyze all the data based on their categories like images, audio, video, text, and they regenerate that data which is created by the user and provide it to us. Suppose for an example, recently we have a new year. In this new year, we all started searching in the browser for various new year greetings or wishes. These wishes or greetings have been collected by the data analyst from the web, Facebook posts or Twitter tweets. Whatever we tweets is being collected or being stored in the data, and this data is reused to provide us some information. Arranging of the data. To categorize the data is also very important. We have to arrange the data, maybe based on their size, maybe based on their types. And to store the data is also very important because it is in a huge amount. So to store a bulk amount of data, we require a large amount of resources, not only in hardware, but nowadays we are storing this huge amount of data in clouds, which we will see in our further slides. Next is sharing. This data is shared among us and transferred among us in various formats, which we even can't understand. Okay? This is the life cycle, what is the storing of data, how it is stored, how it is arranged, how it is processed, and how it will be shared and collected. Next. The analysis process is done by the data analyst. In future, there is a great scope for data analyst. To arrange this data, there is a wide number of people who is involved around us to arrange this data and classify this and based on their categories. Now, most important thing is to store this large amount of data. So we have a certain resource known as cloud computing. In cloud computing, we store this data in a virtual format. We don't know from where the data comes and where it goes. We only know the medium through which the data travels. So cloud is a very vast and very good scope which is used by nowadays to store the large amount of data. So one of the technology which is using the cloud computing is a hybrid model. Now suppose you are storing all the documents in a drive, Google Drive format. That is one of the example of a cloud. You store your information in a drive where you actually don't know where it is stored. You only know the virtual information about its storage. So this is a type of hybrid model where you used your direct way to store your data or in the way of a cache memory which is available to you. Next. See how the data is being stored publicly and privately. There are some amount of data which is shared among all of us which we stored in a public manner. And the some amount of data which is stored in a private manner which no one wants to share, that is confidential. For example, in our defense sector, like the data from the intelligence, raw agents or ISI agents, they keep their data secure so that they do not be misused further. Next slide. There are certain characteristics of big data. This is based on the 4 V's and 1 C model. Okay, the 4V stands for volume, variety, versatility and variability, and C stands for complexity. So as the word is given as big data, so the volume of the data is quite large enough to be handled, and it's having a versatility in it because not only the text data but also the data in the form of images, audio, video clips are also present in it. And if we talk about the variability, so it is not even even. The data keeps on changing. Suppose for New Year, you have collected around millions of data. But what about the next week? The next week, the collection of data may be about 50 to 60 lakhs. So it keeps on varying. There is no constant collection of data each and every day. It keeps on changing. Next is complexity. So the data which is collected is actually a large amount, and it is very complex to handle such data. What are the applications of big data? If you have the correct information and the accurate data, then only you are able to provide any improvement in any of the sectors. For example, it may be your health center, it may be your research, it may be in the field of education, it may be any field, but if you have the right data or the correct accurate data, then only you are able to process it, and then only you are able to make a betterment. For example, for an e-commerce site, based on the review and ratings, you buy a product or you judge that product. If the product is having a 5-star, then only you will buy that product. No matter how worse the condition of the product may be, just because majority of people have given them a 5-star rating, you are buying that product. So how important is the data which you have been displayed to you? So that are the various applications of data which is there. Okay, so lastly I conclude is all your information or communication, all the things which is present around us is data. Like we have said that Bhagwan har jagah hote hai, but a scientist believe or a computer science engineer believe that data har jagah hota hai. For a computer science engineer, a data is equivalent to a god. Because if you have a correct data, a useful data, you can transform it to a various big inventions. Thank you. Questions, you can ask.
मैम, आपने जो बताया कि बिग डेटा बैंक में यूज किया जाता है, बिग डेटा इज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ एसिड, एसिड प्रॉपर्टी को फॉलो नहीं करता है, तो जैसे रिकवरी करना है, आइसोलेशन करना, एटोमिसिटी करना है, तो बिग डेटा कैसे कौन सी प्रॉपर्टी यूज करता है? मैंने बोला रिकवरी करना है जैसे, है ना, तो बिग डेटा क्या होता है कि एसिड प्रॉपर्टी को फॉलो नहीं करता है, तो वो कौन सी प्रॉपर्टी यूज करता है ये मैं जानना चाहता हूँ।
सिक्योरिटी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ सिक्योरिटी।
सिक्योरिटी नहीं मैडम, रिकवरी।
रिकवरी के लिए बोल रहे
जी।
व्हाई ट्रांजैक्शंस?
हाँ,
सपोज जैसे ट्रांजैक्शंस जब भी होते हैं तो वो टोटली बिग डेटा पे रिलाय नहीं करते हैं, उनके पास हमेशा एक बैकअप होता है। जैसे कि एक सर्वर पे वो डिपेंडेंट नहीं रहते, अगर सपोज जैसे महाराष्ट्र में अभी रिसेंटली हुआ कि फायर हो गए पूरे बिल्डिंग में, तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि वहाँ का सर्वर कम्प्लीटली डिस्ट्रॉय हो गया। अगर ये जो डेटा होते हैं वो मल्टीपल लोकेशंस पे स्टोर होते हैं, और सिर्फ एक नहीं इनके कई बैकअप्स जो होते हैं वो ऑलरेडी प्रोवाइड होते हैं। तो बैंक एक ऐसा सेक्टर है जहाँ पे हम एरर्स का कोई भी वहाँ पे रोल नहीं है, एरर फ्री हम उसको रखते हैं। तो ट्रांजैक्शंस की जितने भी डिटेल्स है वो करेक्ट करने के लिए वो हमेशा अपना बैकअप लेके चलते हैं, और वहाँ पे मल्टीपल बैकअप्स होते हैं ना कि एक, तो वहाँ पे कोई एरर या कोई भी लॉस का कोई इशू ही नहीं है। Next presentation will be given by Mohan Solanki, Assistant Professor Law, Government, Paktia, PG College, Jagdalpur, Bastar.
Good morning to all of you. My topic is today for presentation is role of information, communication and technology in legal education and legal profession. This topic are given by what Mr. Sanat Sahu. उन्होंने बोला कि मुझे इसको कुछ बोलना चाहिए, इन्होंने बताया कि कुछ आएगा टेक्नोलॉजी के रूप में, तो मैंने कुछ सोचा कि इसमें कुछ लिखा है वो भी कनेक्टिंग विद हायर एजुकेशन, बिकॉज आईसीटी इज नॉट माय सब्जेक्ट बट आई एम कनेक्टिंग विद लॉ ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन इन दिस स्लाइड आई कैन सी ICT important part of legal profession, approach to handle ICT in legal education are not there as the contents. All over the world, research around the world has shown that ICT can improve student learning and improve our teaching method. Increase in student exposure to educational ICT through curriculum integration has been significant. Had positive impact on student achievement, especially in terms of knowledge, understanding, practical skill, presentation skill, electronic evidence and case study in the subject as area such as mathematics, science, law and social study. Now in professional are used electronic evidence in court. ये कुछ कोर्ट का टर्मिनोलॉजी है, इसमें केस लॉज है. Declaring new law in respect of the evidentiary administrative of the content of electronic record. जो evidence है record में जो जाता है, court में कहा गया कि court जो है क्या electronic evidence को accept कर रहा है या नहीं कर रहा है, इस बात पर जो केस था वो इस केस में कहा गया court will be administrative evidence of electronic evidence. तो वहां कोर्ट ने इसको इलेक्ट्रॉनिक एविडेंस के रूप में एक्सेप्ट किया है अकॉर्डिंग टू सेक्शन 85B इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक लीगल एजुकेशन इन्वॉल्व द यूज ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन कम्युनिकेशन एंड एजुकेशनल टेक्नोलॉजीज टू प्रोवाइड टू लॉ टीचर्स विद द एनवायरमेंट एंड टूल्स टू टीच द लॉ विद द फास्ट ग्रोइंग ऑफ द इंटरनेट.
और बाकी सब रंगों को मैं गाली दूंगा, या मैं लाल कट्टरपंथी हो गया, बाकी सबको मैं गाली दूंगा. ये छोला है, इसलिए ह्यूमैनिटी, क्रिएशन, यूनिवर्स, थोड़ा सा कॉन्शियसनेस को अपने ऊपर उठाना है. शिव योग सबके लिए है एंड इट्स नॉट अ रिलीजन टीचिंग, इट्स अ टीचिंग ऑफ पूर्णता. क्योंकि शिव का नाम जो है, जो शिव शब्द है, शी वा मेल एंड फीमेल एनर्जी ऑफ द यूनिवर्स. शिव बोलते हैं अनंत. ये शब्द जो है, जो बीज शब्द है, इसका मतलब ये है, इसकी जो वाइब्रेशन है इट्स इनफाइनाइट. एंड योग का मतलब है यूनिफिकेशन, मर्जिंग. तो ये जो प्रक्रिया है, मैं फाइनाइट हूं, मेरी लिमिटेशंस हैं, मैं ये कर सकता हूं, मैं क्रिएटेड लिमिटेशंस पैदा करी.